Good day, viewers. You are welcome to the Law TV, your number one fantastic reality TV that gives you all that it takes to be enlightened on trending news, such as politics, entertainment, sports, and what have you. If you are new on this channel, kindly click on the subscribe button as well as the already subscribed. So please, don't forget to drop your comment anytime I drop new videos. Thank you. Cha-cha.
Biafra News. Lawyer drags Nnamdi Kanu to ICC, demands his arrest. Nnamdi Kanu, the leader of the Indigenous People of Biafra, IPOB, has been dragged before the International Criminal Court, ICC, in The Hague. A criminal complaint was lodged against Kanu at the ICC by one Thomas Caro of Gaylord Pop LLC, acting on behalf of the incorporated trustees of Make Nigeria Better Initiative, MNBI. In the complaint, the ICC was also asked to order his arrest and prosecution. In the criminal complaint dated 2nd September 2019, the body anchored its complaint against Kanu on the fact that he issued recent visit to Japan to attend the 7th Tokyo International Conference on African Development holding in the city of Yokohama, Japan from August 28 to 30, 2019. According to MNBI, apart from the recent physical attack carried out by the group against former Senate President Senator Ike Ekweremadu by IPOB in Nuremberg, Germany, acting on the orders of the accused, similar threats have also been issued against the five Southeast governors, including Governor David Umahi of Ebonyi, Ifeanyi Ugwuanyi of Enugu, Okezie Ikpeazu of Abia, and Willie Obiano of Anambra State. IPOB also put on notice Ndigbo leaders, such as the President General of the Ohanaeze Ndigbo, Nnia Nwudo, whom it accused of supporting Operation Python Dance, which was launched by the Nigerian Army in the Southeast in 2016. In the wake of protests by IPOB members who were causing havoc and forceful demanding secession from Nigerians, that the ICC prosecutor opens an investigation of the accused on her own accord under Article 15, one of the Roma Statute, that the ICC prosecutor also formally submits to the pretrial chamber of the ICC a request for authorization of an investigation of the accused under Article 15, 3 of the Rome Statute, that the ICC prosecutor obtain international arrest warrant for the accused from the ICC in accordance with Article 58, 1A, 58, 1BI, 58 1B 2 and 58 1B 3 and proceed to arrest the accused from wherever he is hiding so he can face their trial. That the ICC prosecutor compels the accused upon conviction under the Rome Statute to pay the sum of $1 million as punitive damage for causing death, injury, and maiming of several Nigerians through his act of terrorism. That the ICC prosecutor compels the British government to expeditiously begin the process of cancelling the citizenship of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, entering an exclusion decision and or order barring him from all territories of the United Kingdom so he can return to Nigeria and face his treasonable felony trial pending before Honorable Justice Mrs. Binta Nyako, sitting at the Federal High Court, Abuja. Thank you for listening to this news. Viewers, please don't forget your contribution concerning this news are highly important. Don't forget to click on the subscription button and the bell button to receive more updates. Thank you.